Hello and welcome to Clearview Television. We are reaching you live from Nigeria's capital city, Abuja.
This is Abuja, the fastest growing city in the world. Thousands troop in and out of this great place. So, where are you coming from? Far north, south, east, or west? Let's share this wisdom with you about where to stay, considering comfort, prompt services, and above all, adequate security. Zeus Paradise Hotel, number 1 Domenico Gicho Street by Setraco, by Jabi Lake Mall, Mabushi, Abuja. We invite you to get details of this hotel from our website, www.zeusparadise.com. Telephone 0807-050-0062. Zeus Paradise Hotel, complete home away from home.
I am Nkiru Owuli. Embers of fire were literally poured on the Attorney General of the Federation and Minister of Justice, Abubakar Malami, SAN, for slamming southern governors for banning open grazing in the region. While featuring on a sister station, the AGF had said southern governors banning open grazing is the same thing as northern governors banning spare parts trading in the north, considering the fact that southerners constitute the majority of spare parts traders in the north. 2 weeks ago, the 17 southern governors resolved after a meeting in Asaba, the Delta State capital, to, among other things, ban open grazing and movement of cattle by foot in the region. Many kidnappings and killings in the southern region have been linked to criminal elements among herders. The southern governors also called for restructuring of the country to bring about fiscal federalism, devolution of powers, and state policing. Malami picked holes in the banning on open grazing, describing it as illegal and unconstitutional. The Christian Association of Nigeria, CAN, in collaboration with the Coalition of Intercessors in Nigeria this Friday in Abuja, held a national breakfast prayer session to intercede for the country to overcome its present security challenges and economic hardship. The breakfast prayer, with the theme "The Birth of a New Nation," brought together political and religious leaders across the country. Clearview TV's Mercy Eke was at the prayer ground and now reports.
The national breakfast prayer took off with a spirit-lifting worship. Thereafter, former head of state, General Yakubu Gowon, who joined the prayers virtually, apologized for his physical absence due to the COVID-19 restriction on age grounds. He acknowledged and appreciated the immense efforts and prayers for the country by dignitaries present and absent. While leading the people in intense prayers for the country, the wartime leader said, "The church has a huge role to play in the divine deliverance of the nation from its present plight and national malaise." However, General Gowon was quick to urge Nigerians never to give up on the country. Exhortation, the senior pastor of Foursquare Gospel Church, Asokoro, Reverend Babajide Oluwadala, likened the present situation of Nigeria to that of Job, who lost all but eventually bounced back. Prophetically, he said, "With righteousness, a new nation is possible even today."
That there is a raging battle, it's obvious, between the kingdom of God and that of Satan over our country. You and I know, of course, the victor, because darkness can never overcome light. The drums of war are beating. The rain of sorrow is about to fall, but it will not fall. Amen.
Quoting copiously from the Holy Bible, Vice President Yemi Osibanjo said the fate of the Nigerian nation had always been in the hands of the children of God.
"We, the salt, are also poured today by prayer and prophecy into the source of our nation's problems. Amen. And as we pray and prophesy, a new nation will be birthed. Amen. One where, like the city to which Elisha went, the land was healed, the people prospered, and peace and joy prevailed. So I speak these words also to our nation. Thus says the Lord, I have healed this water.
Amen.
From it there shall be no more death or violence.
Amen.
this nation, there is a birthing of a new nation.
Amen.
The nation has already been birthed.
Amen.
There is no question about that.
Amen.
Other leaders and clergy also took turns to intercede, pleading for mercy for every sector of the nation. They all urged the body of Christ to stand up for righteousness and integrity, which the birth of a new nation desires.
And I want to say that with God, nothing happens by accident. He is a God of purpose, and His plan will unfold in this country.
This must be my 58th prayer breakfast. What does it produce when we come back next year? What are the changes? You can't keep doing the same thing and expect a different result.
The events came to a close with prophetic declarations for the nation and prayers by the President, Christian Association of Nigeria, CAN, Reverend Supo Ayokunle.
He that rescued Israel by making the way easy is going to deliver us from the assaults of the Aztec. He will deliver us from the assaults of Boko Haram, religious terrorists.
Amen.
He will deliver us from the bandits.
Amen.
He will deliver us from the outlaws.
Amen.
He will deliver us from bad leaders.
Amen.
I think I will hear better in there.
Amen.
In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Mercy Aki, reporting for Clear View Television.
Listen to this truth. We are growing by the day, and our viewership keeps growing on our different platforms. We are inviting you to advertise your goods and services with us at incredibly low rates. And do you have news for us? Script or video, please contact us through our email address, clearviewnewsroom@gmail.com or WhatsApp line 080-650-30300. Again, 080-650-30300. Welcome on board.
Men of the Ogun State Police Command have arrested a 47-year-old woman, Olashile Nasiruddin, for allegedly stabbing her husband, Jimo Nasiruddin, to death for impregnating another woman. The incident happened in Ijebu-Ode during an argument between the woman and her late husband. Clearview gathered that the suspect was the fourth wife of the deceased and worked in the same abattoir with him. The state public police public relations officer, DSP Abimbola Oyeyemi, confirmed the incident in a statement. Oyeyemi noted that the woman stabbed her husband in the leg. He explained that the argument ensued between the couple when the woman reportedly questioned her husband's lover for getting pregnant for him. Thank you for watching. I am Nkiru Obuli.